The war in Syria has now decimated the country for more than 9 years. Many different militant groups have been involved in the fighting, along with the involvement of various world powers. As the Assad regime escalated its use of military force in an attempt to quell the peaceful democratic uprising that began in 2011, various rebel groups came together to form the Free Syrian Army under the leadership of several officers who had defected from the regime. By 2013, the loosely held collaboration of FSA groups had gained control of many of Syria's inhabited areas. Regime bombardment on those liberated areas has caused the majority of civilian casualties and the deaths of over 500,000 people since the conflict began. The emergence of ISIS later on served a key role in undermining rebel control over the years. In the international political arena, the regime exploited the expansion of ISIS in Syria to support its attempts from the revolution's onset to paint the opposition as terrorist extremists. This is best highlighted in 2016, when the regime withdrew its forces from Palmyra, giving it to ISIS without a fight. The regime clearly revealed its priorities, because as they withdrew from Palmyra, they began to close down on rebel-held Aleppo, which at the time had endured a brutal 6-month siege and years of bombardment that had killed thousands of civilians. Opposition forces, already suffering due to the lack of consistent support, suffered further from division as they were forced into fighting on two fronts. Aside from opposition-controlled areas, there is also the autonomous region in northeast Syria that is currently controlled by the Syrian Democratic Forces. The SDF is an alliance that is militarily led by the YPG and supported by the United States to fight ISIS. The YPG is a Kurdish militia that emerged in 2011 and is linked with the PKK, which is a Kurdish political and militant organization that has been involved in armed conflict with Turkey since 1984. The PKK is designated as a terrorist organization by Turkey, the United States, and the European Union. Since the demise of ISIS, the SDF has been increasingly involved in combating Turkish-supported Syrian opposition groups. The regime hasn't been as belligerent in their response to groups operating in the autonomous region, as they do not pose the same threat to Damascus as the opposition. The regime and its Russian and Iranian counterparts continue to focus on fighting the opposition and committing countless war crimes against the civilian population in the liberated areas. Each party involved in the conflict has its own goals. The Assad regime is fighting to maintain its dictatorship and 50-year family rule. Russia is fighting to maintain military control of a geopolitically important country and some economic concessions. Iran is fighting to further ideological and religious goals through maintaining a strong military and security presence in Syria, linking its Hezbollah proxy in Lebanon with Shiite militias in Iraq. Turkey is fighting to secure its southern borders, preventing Kurdish expansion, thus having a say in Syria's future. Israel strategically picks its targets in Syria according to a scheme of no win, no lose for the Assad regime and its supporters. Many Syrian activists and groups, including media and humanitarian organizations, still fight for the opposition's original goal of freedom and dignity for Syrians, while others inevitably got caught up in a proxy war between the involved countries. The fighting is not likely to end anytime soon in a country with destroyed infrastructure and an economy in shambles, in which 90% of Syrians live in poverty and more than half of its original population displaced. The Syrian regime's attempt to suppress the protests of the Syrian people who oppose the corruption and brutality of their government has evolved into a confrontation arena for conflicting regional and international powers. And as the struggle for power drags on, innocent civilians continue to pay the highest price.